It's a football town, you know. I think I'm familiar with the culture there, being that there's a lot of, you know, a lot of similarities between South Range and Western Reserve. I grew up in the area, obviously. I grew up probably 5 miles from the high school. But yeah, the community support's big. And then the other part, you know, being that I'm a local guy, I've always been a local guy, I see Western Reserve players, you know, whether it's waiting in line at Chipotle or, you know, you name it. And I've always been really Campfield Fair. You know, I've always been really impressed by the kids and by the community.
What is your coaching style? What can players expect? What can fans expect to see? What's your coaching style?
Yeah, I mean, I from a football specific standpoint, I think they're going to see a physical team, one that's really well prepared, and one that I think is, you know, to steal the Austin Town Fitch's motto. I think we're going to be new school, old school. You know, a lot of the new school things that are in vogue, you know, scheme wise and whatnot, but a lot of the old school, you know, discipline and attention to detail and, you know, those kinds of things.
What's your message to players? I mean, you maybe haven't talked to all of them yet, and message
Sure.
fans who are so used to winning and that kind of a thing. At this point, you probably would have been able to talk to them, now given the circumstances if they were different with the coronavirus and all. But
Yeah.
what's your message to those people?
I mean, I think obviously the expectations don't change. You know, I'm lucky that I've been around successful programs, you know, almost all my life. Obviously, we're not, you know, we don't consider it to be a rebuilding year or any of that. You know, I've heard people talk about that, and our expectations aren't going to change. We're going to go out, and I think the first thing I told the kids is I'm going to challenge them, and my number one job really is to make sure we're reaching our full potential. You know, whether it be in the community or the classroom and on the field, every day. You know, so whatever that is. And the truth is, I think most coaches and most schools, I would say, would agree that, and it's you're never going to reach your full potential in anything, and you know, whether it's business or you know, in a marriage or whatever. But I think that if we can, the guys that get the closest to realizing their full potential, are obviously the ones that I think enjoy the most success. So yeah, I would say, you know, the expectations aren't going to change. We're going to try to reach our full potential every day.
And then the last thing is, what do you know about what you have to work with? Of course, you won't know till you get out on the field or
Sure, yeah.
that kind of thing. But it seems like that program continues to kind of reload year after year.
Yeah.
Specifically, how thrilled are you to be able to work with the personnel that you will have when you finally get back on the field?
Yeah, again, I'm lucky in that, you know, I'm not taking over a program that doesn't have numbers, right? Or doesn't have obviously great players. I just got my Huddle account activated here a couple weeks ago. So I was able to get on and start watching some of the old film, some of the old practice film, and then the games from last year. And you know, I think the thing that stands out to me on the film, and this is one of the reasons I really had a lot of respect for the program prior to joining it. You see guys flying around, you know, players flying around, they're playing their tails off, and it's not, you know, emotional playing their tails off for the first 10 plays of the game. I mean, it's the fourth quarter and they're still, you know, playing like their hair's on fire. So definitely excited about that. Obviously, you know, from a skill standpoint, you know, we'll have to, you know, meet with them and get to see it in person. But I'm definitely impressed by what I see on the film.